All right, Roxanne, you have details from a controversial relationship coach, right?
Yeah, I sent you this earlier in the week. And I feel like we've talked about this guy before. He's an Australian love coach. His name is Jake Maddox.
Never heard of him.
And so he
Jake
gives
what?
Maddox. Maddock.
Yeah, Jake Matt. M-A-D-D-O-C-K.
Mm-hmm. And so okay. He has given out relationship advice in the past.
Oh, he's from Brisbane.
Brisbane. Okay.
It's Brisbane?
Brisbane, not Brisbane. You're the bane of my existence in Brisbane. Go ahead.
So he's the two pieces of information he's given out that people are like, whoa, okay. The first thing is he says you're supposed to cohabitate 6 to 9 months into dating. If you don't do it, if you do it before that, it could wreck the relationship. And if you do it after that, it's not good. Maybe it means you guys just don't like each other that much.
The best time for couples to move in together to cohabitate is 6 to 9 months into dating.
When did you and Michelle move in, or did you wait until you were married?
Hang on. I'm telling you right now, Michelle and I didn't move in together. We were engaged when we moved in together.
Really?
Yeah. I knew Michelle for, let's see, I met Michelle in March of 88. We got engaged in the summer of 93. So I dated Michelle for what? Five years?
Wait. Say that again. You met her when?
I met Michelle in March of 1988.
Oh, I thought you said 90. Okay.
No.
March of 88. Got it.
And then we got engaged in the summer of 93. We got married in the summer of 94.
So wow. You had your own places for 5 years.
Well, also in the meantime, I was in New York and Los Angeles. I went to L.A. first. I left Virginia Beach to go to L.A. for a couple of years. Then I was in New York. And then we met, we were dating a little bit, and then we stopped, and then we kind of rekindled when I moved to New York, and then she came up to visit. Then I left New York to get my first morning show job in West Palm Beach here in Florida, and then Michelle started coming down to Florida a little bit, and then I proposed to her, and we got engaged, and then she moved down.
What a story.
She moved in with me. Yeah, so that was much more than 6 to 9 months.
Right, you're outside this guy's sweet spot, and look how happy you are. So this is BS. All right, so the next thing that he wants to talk about is how many times a week you should have sex.
Okay.
How many times should you have sex?
And does it vary according to age? I would imagine that it might be. Okay.
Nope.
All right, so These are couples that are just together as a couple, or are these married couples, or it's just a relationship?
Partner.
All right. So what is he claiming? What does this Matic guy from Brisbane say?
2 to 3 times a week because it's good for your mental and physical health and hormonal regulation.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Andrew wants us to take phone calls here. So phones are coming in. What are they saying, Andrew?
He wants to say how long it was before he moved in.
Okay.
All right. I'll grab some calls on this. 800-990-1047. So how long was it before you guys moved in together after dating? All right. 800-990-1047. 800-990-1047.
Or how many times a week do you have sex?
Okay, we'll take both. All right. 800-990-1047. And this guy says that this is how you have a good relationship?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
This is how to have a good relationship?
All right. Let's go. Fire up the phones. Do you agree with this guy that you should cohabitate, you should move in together within 6 to 9 months, and you should be doing it 2 to 3 times a week?
I'm not afraid to say it. I would do it every day if I didn't have a job and children.
Okay. Thank you, Roxanne.
Whoa.
Because those are what you call anti- aphrodisiacs.
Oh, the kids?
Working kids.
Oh, I got you. Working kids. All right. All right. Let's grab calls. 800-990-1047. Kyle is up first here. Kyle, you're on the MJ Morning Show. Which part of this you want to comment on?
So I'm the idiot that wrote the stupid Fester phone number song.
Oh, hold on. That was you?
We love you.
That's not stupid.
Oh, wait a sec.
You're getting a lot of traction on
that. Hang on, but folks, listen. This is Kyle. Kyle wrote this and sent this in. the Fester phone number song for Fester's personal private cell number.
Fester, Fester, how can we text you? You give us jokes we can hold on to. I know you think we are a bunch of bozos. Froggy, put your number on the show. Fester, I got your number.
This is Kyle.
I need to send you mine. Fester, don't change your number. 310-8444.
813.
310-8444.
310-8444. 310-8444. All right, so there it is. Nice job, Kyle. Are you a professional singer?
Absolutely not. The acoustics in my apartment with my microphone are not great. So hopefully Fester enjoys my HBO Max and my Paramount Plus
password. Oh, you're the guy that gives the passwords to Fester as well.
Oh, all right, nice.
Kyle, my lines are loaded here, so let's talk about...
I know.
All right, okay.
So we moved in. I just got married last month, and I sent Fester all the photos of our wedding. And we lived in the same apartment complex, but two different apartments for almost a year and a half. So now...
Well, that wasn't cost-effective.
Not very, but it couldn't have come at a better time for our wedding with all this inflation, because after we move out of this apartment, it will go from $1,045 a month to $1,550 a month.
They are raising the rent that much in your apartment complex? Holy
Absolutely,
moly.
Yes. Hey, here's the thing. In Temple, Texas, they're building a brand new Facebook Meta facility that'll add 5,000 jobs to the area in a town that only has 60,000 people.
That is crazy. So housing's going to be at a premium. Supply and demand going to push prices up. Kyle, thank you, buddy. Appreciate the call. Pam is in Newport Richey. Hey, Pam, you're on the MJ Morning Show. Hi.
Hi, good morning. You guys are absolutely wonderful. Thank you for being here in the mornings with us.
You realize that I have not re-signed the contract.
Oh, God.
I know, but I'm hopeful.
Yeah, and listen, I'm not turning it into a bit. I don't want to exploit the situation, but I have not signed the new contract. Nope.
MJ's contract countdown.
Nope. Haven't signed yet.
Okay, well, I hope the next one is positive.
MJ's contract countdown.
Yeah, and contract's up next month. I'm sorry. Go ahead, Pam.
Well, I was calling about the moving in. My husband and I, we met in May of 87. And then in January of 88, we moved in together. And then February of 89, we got married.
Gotcha.
And we've been married happily almost 34 years.
That's
February.
Fantastic. Now, you're a little outside of the window because this guy says you're supposed to cohabitate 6 to 9 months into the dating. You guys waited almost a year, right?
No, 7 months.
Wait a minute. Oh, hold on. So, my math sucked. Yeah. Hold on. You said May of 87?
Yes, and then January of 88.
Oh, okay. My bad. All right. Yeah. All right.
That's okay.
Bad math here. Maybe I shouldn't resign.
So, and we've been happily married. We have two children. We've moved all around, and we're just going strong.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it, Pam. Keenel is in Wesley Chapel. Have a great day. Keenel in Wesley Chapel, MJ Morning Show. Welcome.
Hi, MJ. Hey, Roxanne. Hey, Froggy.
Hey.
And hi, Fester, even though you're not there.
Yeah, he's in his car. So, he's probably listening on his way to his kids' Thanksgiving celebration program at school.
Give you a wheeze.
Yeah. Let's hope the car makes it take some time.
There's Fester and his wheeze laugh. There's Weezer himself.
Okay. So I moved in with my husband now about a year and a half to 2 years into dating him. We lived together for just over 2 years before we got married in May of 2015. Yeah, and about the sleeping together.
Yeah, I was gonna let Roxanne ask you the question, but however, you're just blurting it out. So yeah, go ahead.
Yes. Well, you know, right now we have two kids under five, so mm-hmm. it's a little hard to do that 2 to 3 times a week. But before we had kids, yeah, 2 to 3 times a week was the good equation for it.
Right, you do it 2 to 3 times a week, and then you get those little kids, and they cut you back.
They mm-hmm. screw it all up.
Yeah, I know. They really do set you back, man.
Yep. Actually, it would be anti-screwing it all up, I think. All right, hey, listen, thank you, Keenel. Yep. Appreciate you listening. It would be the opposite, right? It would be mm-hmm. the reciprocal. Sylvie is in Tampa. Hey, Sylvie, welcome to the MJ Morning Show. Hi.
Hi, good morning. I got a doozy for you.
What do you have?
I met my husband in December, moved in by February, and married by June.
Whoa, you met your husband in December, you moved in by February?
Did you have a baby on the way?
By June.
And then you were married by June?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I think it was we were playing the celebrity.
Was it a shotgun wedding?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it was.
Well, all right.
There you go.
That explains it.
All righty. Hey, Sylvie, thanks for the call. Have a great day.
All right, thanks.
Thanks. One more. Let me grab Miguel in Spring Hill. Hey, Miguel, you're on the MJ Morning Show. Hi.
Good morning, MJ. Good morning, everybody.
Hey.
Thank you for the tablet. I did win it yesterday.
Miguel.
Yeah.
Hi.
Yeah, Miguel won. You won the 7 o'clock hour tablet on Tuesday. Wow. Hey, thank you, buddy.
I appreciate that. And I do want to comment on this. I have a year and a half going, a little bit more, I think. Relationship. She met me and 3 days later moved in, and it's been fine. It's been great. As far as the sex question, it has been every day, so we're doing good there.
Wow.
And, all right, Miguel. Winner of laptops and a winner of all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
I'm definitely on the ball, I guess.
Wow.
I get it.
But yeah,
very every day, man. You're talking Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
It's like breakfast, Miguel. Right? Sometimes it's a brunch. Sometimes you eat it in the car while you're, you know, putting makeup on.
Exactly. You
man,
know,
you said breakfast. You know, breakfast would be Rudy Tooty Fresh and Fruity. This is like Rudy Tooty Fresh and Booty. You know,
you eat it in the car,
5
huh?
5 a.m. breakfast. Yeah. You know,
Rudy Tooty Fresh and Booty. Maybe cootie, I don't know. Oh, hey, thank.
It's been good.
Hey, Miguel, thank you, buddy. Thanks for being an active participant on the MJ Morning Show.
Thank you for having the show. I love the show. You guys are great.